Good afternoon. We are on the 1st of March 2022. I'm going to be sharing with you daily meditations with Saint Augustine. And I'm dedicating all the prayers today for a miracle for my neighbour Tom. The doctor said he needs a miracle to survive, to live. He's fighting. Praise the Lord. So we'll just trust in God for his mercy and compassion. Dedicate all these prayers. Thank you, Susan, and many others who are praying with me, all praying together for God's will for this lovely man's life, to be merciful and compassionate, to give him a little longer with his loved ones, who are absolutely distraught. He was fine last week. Went shopping with him to Lidl, as is normal for us with his son. So just keep praying. And thank you for yours, especially you, Susan. Remember, O most loving Virgin Mary, that it's a thing unheard of that anyone ever had recourse to your protection, implored your help or sought your intercession and was left forsaken. Fill therefore with confidence in your goodness, I fly to you, Mother, O Mother Virgin of Virgins, to come to you. Before you I stand, a sorrowful sinner. Despise not my poor words, O Mother of the Word of God, but graciously hear and grant my prayer for Tom. Amen. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here, ever this day be at my side to light and guard, to rule and guide. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Holy Michael, Archangel, defend me in this day of battle. Be my safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, I humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust down to hell Satan and all the wicked evil spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who have most need of thy mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Father, send forth now your Spirit over all the earth. I'll continue with the readings for daily meditations with Saint Augustine, March 1. And the title for March 1, first, is Even Sinners Are to Be Treated with Human Consideration. Almsgiving, which is not to be made light of, particularly this Lent is beginning tomorrow, is bestowed on any poor person by right of humanity, seeing that the Lord himself relieved the wants of the poor, even from those funds which were supplied from other people's contributions. The most dastardly of sinners are, of course, those who hate and persecute the church, and yet about them we are told, do good to those who hate you. And this is supported by the example of God the Father, who makes his Son rise on the good and the bad and sends his rain on the just and the unjust. The prayer for the 1st of March. Help us, Lord, to be tireless in doing good. Amen. I'm also going to share with you February the 29th, because we didn't have one. What God made in us is good. God sent his Son to redeem us. We have received this grace. Let us live worthily of what we have received. Let us do no wrong to so great a grace. Such a splendid doctor has come to us. He has forgiven all our sins. If we are determined to get sick again, we shall not only be very damaging to ourselves, but also ungrateful to the doctor. We're talking of spiritual sickness here, not physical. We're praying for physical healing, and a spiritual one maybe, for Tom. Maybe if he comes out of this, he'll be even stronger in his faith than before. But we have to depend on a miracle, because the doctors have said there is nothing else they can do. It's a serious condition he's in right now, but he's fighting. So the prayer, make me, Father, search for you and protect me and you and us from evil. And as we search, let there be nothing else for us other than you. Amen. So as it's Saint Augustine's prayers, I'm going to share some of Saint Augustine's prayers at plural. So prayers of Saint Augustine, devotion to God. O Lord Jesus, let me know myself, let me know you, and desire nothing else but you. Let me hate myself and love you, and do all things for the sake of you. Let me humble myself and exalt you, and think of nothing but only you. Let me die to myself and live in you, and take whatever happens as coming from you. Let me forget myself and walk after you, and ever desire to follow you. Let me flee from myself and turn to you, so that I may merit to be defended by you. Let me fear for myself. Let me fear you, and be amongst those who are chosen by you. Let me distrust myself and trust in you, and always pray for the love of you. Let me cling to nothing but only to you. Look upon me that I may love you. Call me that I may see you, and forever possess you. Amen. I'm going to pray for my friend Tom. O sweet Lord Jesus, give him a heart to love you, a will to choose you, a memory to remember you, a mind to think of you, a soul which may always be united to you. And may you, the God of love and mercy, love him, Tom, forever. Amen. And we always have hope. We must always have hope. So the prayer for hope is for Tom. I beg of you, my God, let me know you and love you, so that I may be happy in you. And though I cannot do this fully in this life, yet let me improve from day to day, till I may do so to the full. Let me know you more and more in this life, that I may know you perfectly in heaven. Let me know you more and more here, so that I may love you perfectly there, so that my joy may be great in itself here, and complete in heaven with you. O truthful God, let me receive the happiness of heaven which you promise, so that my joy may be full. In the meantime, let my mind think of it, let my tongue talk of it, let my heart long for it, let my mouth speak of it, let my soul hunger after it, let my flesh thirst after it, let my whole being desire it, until such a time as I may enter through death into the joy of my Lord, there to continue forever, world without end. Amen. And because we're coming into Lent tomorrow, Ash Wednesday, you should go to Mass and receive ashes on our head. Prayer in honour of the Passion by Saint Augustine. O Lord Jesus Christ, who to save all men was born, circumcised, rejected by the Jews, bound with chains, led like an innocent lamb to sacrifice, shamefully brought before Annas and Caiaphas, before Pilate and Herod, accused by false witnesses, beaten with whips, hit upon the head, insulted, spat upon, crowned with thorns, struck with a reed, blindfolded and mocked, stripped of your clothes, fastened with nails to the cross, lifted up in the company of thieves, made to drink gall and vinegar, and wounded with a spear. Oh, by all these sacred sufferings, deliver me, Lord, from the pains of hell, and lead me to heaven, where you led the good thief who was crucified by your side. Amen. God bless you all. Thank you so much for listening. Sending you prayers of healing and God's peace in abundance, and may you always be happy and joyful in the Lord. And thank you so much for praying for Tom, and I'd ask you to continue to pray for him. I will keep you informed as and when I know and have more news. But we just keep praying in faith and pray for his eternal soul and salvation. None of us know what relationship anyone has with God. We pray for our own and our family, our loved ones, and for others to be right with God. God bless you all. Thank you so much. I'm beginning to feel it that I didn't go to bed till 4 a.m. My own fault completely. I can't blame anyone else. God bless you. Bye-bye.